it doesn't matter how of a high-end lab it is, or if it's a bargain basement lab or somewhere in between, underreduction is the number one issue. And technicians often wanna know, why do dentists underreduce so much? And especially here at Glidewell, I get asked the question by technicians all the time, why the underreduction? I try to put a good spin on it, and I say, you know, and I say, what I say is the truth. I say we are very conservative by nature, and we want to remove the least amount of tooth structure possible. And that is true. But that's not why we underreduce. I mean, it's true that we don't want to take off any more than we need to, but we underreduce because we don't measure how much we're reducing. Step 7 is the lingual reduction. I'll usually mark this with a piece of articulating tape, and wherever that lower anterior tooth is hitting, if I'm doing zirconia, I'll put a 1/6 of a millimeter depth cut right through that blue mark. If it's Emax, I'll put a 1 millimeter one. And then I'll just use this 379023 burr to make sure that depth cut disappears. I prep all that away, and now I know I've got enough room for my lower anterior tooth and enough strength for my material. And then I just use the football burr to blend that depth cut with the rest of the lingual surface so that it's concave. So after that's done, the prep is almost essentially done. We have one more step after we pack this cord. This is the top cord in this technique, a size 2 cord. It's actually a 2E cord from Ultradent, and the E stands for epinephrine. And I started using an epi cord like this when I heard Gordon Christensen talk about using it. Oh, this is probably 15 years ago. And I said, I heard they weren't safe. And he said, well, my rationale is I use an epi cord on any patient who can tolerate epinephrine in the local anesthetic injection. And if they can't, I don't use an epi cord. I use a plain cord. And, you know, in my whatever, he said, 40 years of being a prosthodontist at the time, it's working very well. And so I just kind of adopted that same philosophy of do what Gordon does. And again, my goal here is to not only reduce enough for the technicians, but give them literally the best impression that I'm capable of doing, because I know they're judging me hard, not only on my reduction, but on my impressions as well. So if I can put a 2-chord technique and then have the top chord have some epi in it so that we don't have any bleeding, I'm gonna do that. In fact, we'll do one more thing. We have a 3-part approach to taking great impressions, none of them which have to do with skill. The water's now turned off. I have my 856025 burr spinning at 1000 RPMs, and I'm starting on the lingual and going around and smoothing my margins. I'm looking at this at 5X through my loops